Okay, so this is just a quick trip through some headlines that are climate related, because in March it shattered a century-long record by the greatest margin seen yet for any month. February was far above the long-term average, and so, you know, and I don't know, this is just going through the headlines, sharing some headlines with a little opinion. It was a really wet winter and very cold for me anyways here in northern Nevada. And then we're coming over here. Oh, and just for the record, quick digression. It's Nevada. We eat bananas in Nevada, not bananas in Nevada. It's a real pet peeve of Nevadans. Anyways, there's the digression. So, can we gauge the impact of climate change on extreme weather? While scientists have long avoided attributing specific extreme weather events to changes in global climate, a recent report suggests that some of these events can be attributed to climate change with a high degree of confidence. The report is from the National Academies of Sciences, Engineering, and Medicine, and marks the first time that scientists have tried to integrate all the information that might allow them to link weather to climate change. So, it goes on to say, if you think of this as a baseball diamond, maybe we're down to first base now, he says. Maybe we've got off of home plate. We're not just swinging at the pitches anymore. And maybe in the case of heat, we're even taking a look at second base. But for some events, however, like severe thunderstorms and tornadoes, we're still in the batter's box. And then we go over here to Nature World News, where it is, alert, Greenland's ice now melting at catastrophic speed. Greenland ice melted on Monday at such a catastrophic speed that scientists could hardly believe it. It was such an extreme melt event that experts had to check if they were making a mistake. The ice meltdown this year has broken records for the earliest area melt dates by almost a month. A study released in April stated that the catastrophic speed of the ice melt in Greenland could be a result of natural geothermal activity from underneath the Greenland ice sheet. Experts, on the other hand, are looking at the warming of the climate and higher frequency of rain as the possible reasons behind the rapid increase in the amount of ice melt. Continuous melting of ice sheets is increasing the seawater level, rising concern to many. NASA reported in September 2015 that despite the continuous effort to slow down climate change, the world is in for at least 3 feet of water level increase, as per CNN. So we're going to move over here. Here we are today. Houston largely shut down amid rain and flooding. More than a foot of rain in some places. And they have had, now we're going to see, the latest second possible fatality in the Houston flooding. Texas is being hit by flash floods and tornadoes. I don't know. There's a lot of weather headlines. Here we have this climate-related death of coral around world alarms scientists. And again, I don't know what the truth is on the climate change, but I just wanted to share some of these headlines, like this one out of Sydney. Kim Cobb, a marine scientist at the Georgia Institute of Technology, expected the coral to be damaged when she plunged into the deep blue waters off of Kiritimati Island, a remote atoll near the center of the Pacific Ocean. Still, she was stunned by what she saw as she descended some 30 feet to the rim of a coral outcropping. The entire reef is covered with red-brown fuzz, Dr. Cobb said when she returned to the surface after her recent dive. It is otherworldly. It is algae that has grown over dead coral. It was devastating. So it goes on, coral reefs are the crucial incubators of the ocean's ecosystem, providing food and shelter to a quarter of all marine species, and they support fish stocks that feed more than 1 billion people. So this is just, it goes on, and all these articles are linked if you'd like to get further into it. I just wanted to share some headlines. That's what I'm doing with the 3-minute news. So I hope it makes you go, that's interesting.